Almost done. After today, there will be only one. Oklahoma State, a repeat national champion in the 40s, is trying to recapture the glory of yesteryear. UMass has no Final Four history, only an all-or-nothing refuse-to-lose attitude. Meadowlands Arena, East Rutherford, New Jersey, about a 20-minute drive on a good day from Midtown Manhattan. That's assuming the tunnel is not clogged. And we're here for the East Regional Final. The Oklahoma State Cowboys with 26 victories this season against the UMass Minutemen, who are in quest of their 30th of the year. And the winner of this game will join UCLA and North Carolina in the Final Four. The winner of this game takes on UCLA next Saturday in Seattle. And good afternoon, everybody. Vern Lundquist along with Quinn Buckner. Glad to have you with us. First of all, a little medical information. Edgar Padilla, the starting guard for UMass, is not going to be able to play. He strained an arch in the game here the other night, tried to run this morning. We are told, Quinn Buckner, he will be available, but only in an emergency. Now, how does that impact on the team?
You know, what it does for UMass, that's a team that likes the pressure. And when you want to pressure the way they do, you need a lot of substitutions. It shortens that substitution pattern, one. He's also one of their best outside shooters. Now you have to be concerned about getting the ball inside to Marcus Camby and Lou Rowe without having Padilla on the floor. But most importantly, it's the pressure that's going to be effective.
Well, the mention of Camby and Rowe brings smiles to everybody who cares about the UMass program. Really a talented front court duo.
Well, they really are. I mean, they do a lot of things for you. Marcus Camby is a guy you like because he can help block shots. But the heart and soul of this team is Lou Rowe. He's a big, strong young man, gets down on the block, does the dirty work. John Calipari cannot say enough good things about this guy, but he's going to have to bring it tonight because he's going to have to guard Big Country.
Well, Oklahoma State comes in, as we said, with 26 victories. What is the key for them today?
Well, I think the key is tempo. I think you've got to be able to get into a half-court game, and their defense will work on the other side. They're one of the top defensive teams in the country, but what you got to do is, in terms of the tempo, get it half-court, because if you can get it to half-court, you've got Brian Reeves in there. He is not only 7 feet tall, but he's a wide body, and he can turn back the defense off you and still make the shot. So they've got to make sure that they can do that. But in order to get there, they've got to be able to shoot it from the perimeter. They shot it pretty well against Wake Forest, but the guy that's going to have to shoot it the best, their best shooter, is Randy Rutherford. He's had 45 points against Kansas. He had 23 the other night against Wake Forest. He's got to come out knocking down the jump shot.
UMass has never been to the Final Four. Oklahoma State was last there 44 years ago. Back with the starting lineups right after this.
CBS Sports exclusive.
Let's go to our public address announcer, Bill Bromberg.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Vern Meadowlands Arena in East Rutherford, New Jersey, for today's Eastern Regional Championship game between the Oklahoma State University Cowboys and the University of Massachusetts Minutemen. Let's meet the starting lineups. At forward for Oklahoma State, a 6'9 senior from Euless, Texas, number 20, Scott Pierce. At forward for Massachusetts, a 6'6 junior from the Bronx, New York, number 3, Dana Dinkle. At forward for Oklahoma State, a 6'6 senior from Joliet, Illinois, number 32, Terry Collins. At forward from Massachusetts, a 6'7 senior from Atlantic City, New Jersey, number 15, Lou Rome. At center for Oklahoma State, a 7-foot senior from Gans, Oklahoma, number 50, Bryant Reeves. At center for Massachusetts, a 6'11 sophomore from Hartford, Connecticut, number 21, Marcus Camby. At guard for Oklahoma State, a 6'3 senior from Broken Bow, Oklahoma, number 15, Randy Rutherford. Guard from Massachusetts, a 6'2 senior from Springfield, Massachusetts, number 14, Derek Kellogg.
Baby, Springfield, baby. Woo!
At guard to Oklahoma State, a 5'11 junior from South Bend, Indiana, number 35, Andre Owens. And at guard from Massachusetts, a 6'2 sophomore from Boston, Massachusetts, number 24, Carmelo Travieso.
Ooh, let's do this shit!
And introducing the head coaches for Oklahoma State, Eddie Sutton, and for Massachusetts, John Calipari.
And now before we tip it off here in East Rutherford, let's check in with Andrea Joyce.
Vern, at this time of year, most teams are wearing down physically, but UMass in particular really got banged up and re-aggravated some old injuries on Friday night. Here's a list of the wounded. Derek Kellogg has a strained tendon in his left foot. Marcus Camby, tendonitis around the knees. Lou Rose, strained hamstring. Padilla's injury, however, is much more severe. Trainer Ron Laham told us that they made a special insert for his shoe to try and relieve some of the pressure on his arch. He tested it out during warm-up, though, and he didn't look good at all. Padilla just told us a couple of minutes ago he's in plenty of pain. So as you said, Vern, it would only be in an emergency situation if he were to get in. Back to you guys.
Okay, Andrea. Oklahoma State is not deep. They do have one injury. It's Terry Collins, the guard who has a torn tendon on his index finger of his shooting hand. It did bother him the other night. Here's how Oklahoma State advanced over Drexel, Alabama, and then they knocked off the number one seed Wake Forest the other night. They got big help off the bench from Keani Roberts. And UMass came in as the number two seed. And look at the margin of victory for the Minutemen in each of the three games. 17 in the first, 22 in the second, and then they rolled over Tulsa in their victory here Friday night. The officials for today's game, the referee is Andre Patillo, and it is Patillo, Don Rutledge, and Steve Wellmer. First meeting ever between these two teams. UMass 29-4, and Oklahoma State 26-9.
The most important thing you can try to do in any basketball game is make the team play, the opposition play your game. Critical for Oklahoma State to be able to slow the game down.
Derek Kellogg for UMass.
Oklahoma State out in traditional man-to-man.
Kellogg comes right side to Dana Dingle. Low post, Marcus Camby goes at Reeves, gets it off. Basket is good. Dana Dingle.
Well, you can see what Marcus Camby can do. He not only can go to the basket with his quickness, but he makes a nice pass inside. So now you got to be worried about his passing ability.
Full court pressure applied. Now they drop back. Applied the pressure on the inbound pass. Andre Owens at the point, number 35. Underneath it goes to Big Country Reeves. Foul.
Having a shooter out there makes all the difference in the world. Marcus Camby was down on the block trying to guard Big Country. And the problem he's going to have is, as I said, Bryant Reeves is wide, so it's hard for you to get over him to get to the shot. So he just needs to go straight up and not go after every shot. Talk to the coaching staff. They were concerned that Marcus Camby would start going after every shot.
Reeves at the free throw line. He has been extraordinary at the line in the NCAA tournament. He's now made 25 of 28, and for the season, only a 70% shooter.
Yeah, he's stepped up to the plate big. And this young man has had an outstanding college career.
Happened again.
Well, we jinxed him.
Does all the time. 2-1. Back to Dingle. Gamby out to set a screen high. Almost picked off by Owens. He had six steals the other night. Left side, Dingle. Oh, good reversal of position in the air, and Dingle is fouled.
You know, here's what you've got to watch for defensively with Oklahoma State. If they are playing defense and taking charges, they are in good shape. And the difference is, if they're not taking charges, that means the dribble penetration is beating them, and that quickness allows them to get to the basket, and that's what's going to hurt Oklahoma State if they allow UMass dribble penetration.
Neither of these teams known for their free throw shooting proficiency. As a team, UMass 66%, but Dingle, the least effective of them all, he's 55% for the season, but he got the first. And the second.
He's going to start it. The count has already started.
Got starts. Gary Collins inbounds to Scott Pierce. Blue Rowe back on him.
So they'll come and blind tap you. Turn it over, obviously, but it's one thing to turn it over with a travel, if you will, but it's a whole different thing if you turn it over on a steal because they can convert it.
This is Rutherford, guarded by Carmelo Travieso. There's the tip to Dingle. Another turnover. Oklahoma State turned it over only six times in their win the other night against Wake Forest.
And this is the tempo Massachusetts wants. They want to speed up your offense.
Matter of fact, the last two games, they've turned it over six in each. Twice already. Off the glass, no good. Rebound, Scott Pierce of Oklahoma State. Now Andre Owens in his first year. Junior college transfer, the entry pass to Brian Reeves. Off the mark, rebound, Travieso. Derek Kellogg.
See how, they're back, how fast they're back on the offensive end. Travieso knocks down the three. They get you before you can really set up.
Carmelo Travieso, who is starting in place of the injured Edgar Padilla. Offensive foul. Eddie Sutton's going to his bench.
Well, you know that Camby can block shots. There he goes down pretty hard. And there's no question about the charge, but Terry Collins was out of control.
Dante Bright checks in and replaces Marcus Camby. And for Oklahoma State, it's Keontae Roberts, number 23, who had a big game off the bench the other night. 13 points and 6 rebounds.
And he's an athlete. He's very versatile. And they got him on the floor because Terry Collins is really out of sync.
9-1. We play 2.5. Kellogg and Travieso. Here's Dante Bright. Intercepted by Andre Owens. Dips it left side. Rutherford to the three. No good.
Vern, he had a layup. I mean, I understand kicking the ball out. And Keontae Roberts is telling him, take the layup. There's no need to throw it out for a three under those circumstances.
Take a look at it. Up. Inbounds. Here's Rutherford. Knocked out by Dante Bright.
The real strength of UMass is not only the kind of pressure they put on you, they are very, very intense with that pressure. They keep it on you on both ends of the floor.
Both of these teams defensively oriented, and they excel in that aspect of the game. Here's Scott Pierce. He was 0 for 7 on Friday night. Now Pierce. Off and it goes off Travieso. UMass almost had their third steal.
Yeah, well, with Spears, is really, I don't think he understands the kind of players he's playing against. These guys have got great savvy, so if you beat them, they're generally going to come from behind, either on a press or even a half-court set. He's got to protect the basketball.
Eddie Sutton said he wanted a game in the 60s. He can't be pleased with what's going on, even in terms of tempo right now.
No, the tempo is definitely favors UMass. This is the way they want it to go.
Well, Scott Pierce, 0 for 7 in Friday night's game. Cans his first basket today. Young man who started as a sophomore at Illinois and then transferred to Oklahoma State. Andre Owens goes for the steal off his foot. UMass Well, inbound. Well, we talked about defense. Look at UMass throughout the tournament, Glenn.
Well, what they do is they not only get after you full court, but in the half-court game, they come out. You rarely get an uncontested shot. That's what leads to that kind of opposition in terms of field goal percentages.
Tyrone Weeks has come on the floor now. Weeks and Rowe. Here's Kellogg. Lou Rowe, the trap comes from the double team from Roberts.
See, they're more worried about Lou Rowe than they were about Marcus Camby. As you see, Dana Dingle getting a jump shot. But they came with double team Rowe. They did not double team Camby.
Camby on the bench after he took the charge from Collins. It's an 11-3 game, 15-53 remaining. Back to Pierce.
Now this is the tempo they want.
On the baseline, Andre Owens.
That's an out on Rowe. On the ground, there's no doubt about it. He reached in. And I don't know why he's doing that, because that is Andre Owens. There's no chance he's going to get that one over him very successfully.
Basket did not count. The foul there.
Has to read it, get in the middle. He doesn't. Lou Rowe anticipates, and that's what ignites the fast break for UMass.
That last foul prior to the timeout was changed and given now to Damon Dingle instead of Lou Rowe. So Dingle has one, two team fouls. Here's Rutherford off the front iron. He's missed 2 3-pointers now. He is the fourth all-time single-season three-point maker in NCAA history.
He is not gunshot.
No.
And get it going.
He's popped it up from out there, 320-330 now. Underneath Reeves.
You cannot let anybody get that close, but that's another sign of that big body. When he turned, Marcus Camby got jammed, so he couldn't jump.
Marcus Camby is back in the lineup now, joined by Travieso, Lou Rowe, Dante Bright, and Derek Kellogg. Here's Kellogg, number 14. And a steal. Rutherford for Oklahoma State.
I'm surprised at the mishandling by UMass, because see, they practice against tough defense every day, and that was an unforced error there. They just threw it away.
Kellogg looks for Camby. There's a double from Owens.
Oh,
the ball.
Great
possession there from Oklahoma State.
Oh, very good quickness to the ball. First of all, Kellogg telegraphed the pass, because he looks right at Marcus Camby, and Owens is reading him all the way. See, he's going as soon as the ball is there. And he gets there, and fortunately for UMass, Camby is able to get a hand on it.
Here's Scott Pierce across the timeline. Takes it underneath. Got it.
He is the wild card. I talked to assistant coach that's helping Corey Williams. They said Scott Pierce is the wildcat. He's got a guard, Lou Rowe, and he's capable of having big games like that. They're just not sure what game will show up.
A 6-0 run now for Oklahoma State. They're down by two. Here's Camby, and again the double. Bright open, short, rebound, Tyrone Weeks, number 34.
Well, you get a chance to make some opportunities for yourself. You got to do that. Scott Pierce did a good job pushing the ball up. But here, he challenges Camby with a nice head and shoulder fake. Once Camby goes up, and he couldn't get back up in time to get the block, Scott Pierce was able to get it on that side, but he picked up the foul on this end.
Tyrone Weeks at the line, sophomore from Philadelphia.
Wide body gets down on the block. He's a guy that is very good for the team, because he's of the mold of Lou Rowe. So he's the quote heir apparent to that position.
Connie had a good game off the bench in the win over Tulsa. 7 rebounds to complement 3 baskets. Here's a freshman, Jason Scare, number 43 on the floor for Oklahoma State. And Scott Pierce will get a rest.
Yeah, Scare is a little more of an offensive threat, but this is to give Pierce a break.
I know Padilla's absence affects the depth, but they're still a deeper team, aren't they, than Oklahoma State?
I think they're a deeper team. They play 9 and 10 people, but you've got to be that way if you're going to try to apply the pressure they do full court.
Steal by Kellogg. 4 turnovers now. Oh, what a dandy play to Travieso.
I'm telling you, the shot was even better, because the pass ended up being away from the basket, and Travieso was able to throw it over his head to get it in.
15-9, last 2 baskets for UMass. Here's Keonti Roberts. Right side to Reeves. They kick it back outside to Andre Owens. Gare had a couple of 3-pointers the other night. much more of a perimeter shooting team is Oklahoma State than UMass. Reed.
Tough shot. Yeah, but Camby makes it a tough shot.
Nice play by Rutherford to tip it out. Owens fouled by Kellogg.
You got to understand when you play against UMass, every now and then they'll change up on you. What happens here is Kellogg switches. And Jason Scare didn't read the switch, but the pass gets away here. I mean, he throws the pass. Now, it's away from the basket, and he gets it up over Jason Scare. That was a heck of a play by Travieso.
Ball will be inbounded now by Keontae Roberts. Pierce. Andre Owens, South Bend, Indiana. A couple of junior colleges. First year out, Oklahoma State. Back goes to Reed.
That's a shot. Yes, sir.
See, Lou Rowe is big enough, is strong enough to guard him, but he's not tall enough, and he can just turn around and shoot that turnaround jump shot. He feels comfortable with that shot. Weeks is on him, my mistake, but watch. It's not a problem. He ball faked, and he's just right in rhythm, and there's nothing Weeks can do. See, Camby, if he guards him, can stay there, and if he goes up, he can still get a hand up and get it in his face.
Now Reeves at the free throw line, one of two today.
I'm telling you, he's shooting it good because he shot that one and he was almost out of the free throw circle before he went in. That's confidence.
UMass up by three. Derek Kellogg, the senior from Springfield. There's the double on Camby again. Oh, block. Keontae Roberts with the block and then he knocks it out of bounds.
When you take the ball to the basket, you got to take it strong because you're going to get players coming after you all the time. Keontae Roberts is obviously a guy that just a little bit of anticipation can be passing it. You see Keontae Roberts get that one. But you got to take that back. Reject.
This is not a team that normally blocks that many shots. That's Kellogg. And UMass, of course, is led by Camby. Only 111 blocks for the season compared to 259 for the Minutemen.
Ah, the rebound, the putback. Well, Eddie Sutton was worried about defensive rebound. They're getting offensive rebounds, which has really helped them get the ball back in the basket.
Short, Camby. Tyrone Weeks is fouled.
One of the tough things to do is to pick up people in transition and then make a play. First of all, this is a very difficult shot to be taken, but because their people are not on one another in terms of Oklahoma State and UMass, you see right there, Pierce get inside, get him one, but he also picked up a foul and they have to take him out. The offensive rebound circumstances has Oklahoma State with four, the UMass is two.
This is an Oklahoma State team that through the three games of the tournament has been out-rebounded by a 40-41 margin. Weeks at the line.
But they're still able to win games because they don't turn the ball over a lot. I mean, that's the rebounding, and first of all, it's not a big margin, but if you don't turn it over, you give yourself a chance to get it in.
Well, that's testimony, too, to the defensive effort of this UMass team. Four turnovers already by Oklahoma State. Weeks gets it. Lou Rowe back in. John Calipari paying testament to his senior All-American yesterday. This, when Rowe and Kellogg were freshmen, this team got to the round of 16 down in Philadelphia in 1992. They lost to Kentucky. Lou Rowe and Kellogg played some that year. Here's the...
Oh, yes, he said. Oh, yes. You can see cooking up there.
Certainly made what I was saying here, Roman.
Pause, I had to get that one.
Now then, Travieso, no. Weeks, too strong. Rowe, short. Rebound, Roberts.
I'm telling you, he's been huge off the bench. He made the last pass. Keontae Roberts has just ignited his team. He's blocked shots, he's taken it down twice, dished it off, and just took it in for the score.
Oklahoma State has gone on top by two. Dante Dingle back to Kellogg.
No basket.
No basket. Foul on Oklahoma State.
Oklahoma State.
You need to have somebody come off the bench to help you. You know your big guys will score. You need some help. They got it in Keontae Roberts, Oklahoma State.
Deal.
I never lied to you, Gloria.
Terry Henry Iba. Mr. Iba led the team to back-to-back national championships in 1945 and 46. Here's the ball in the low post to Lou Rowe, in and out. And a foul called. That probably is going to send Tyrone Reese to the
go for face fuzz.
You know, a little bit of the quickness. John Calipari's team is trying to do the same thing Oklahoma State did earlier, and that's get some offensive rebound baskets because he knows his club is struggling. To
feel of a nice, clean, close.
Just a postscript to the Eddie Sutton playing days. He averaged 8.3 points per game, but they got their team into the NCAA tournament.
Well, my experience with Mr. Iver was when 1984 and helping Bob Knight and the Olympic team. Mr. Iver was there the entire time. I mean, and Bob Knight has tremendous respect for those people who've given the history of the game, and I happen to have the same respect. But Eddie Sutton has learned a great deal from Coach Iver, and most of it has to do with the defensive end of the floor.
Reeves out on the top right now. Keyonte Roberts. A rare miss. Here comes Kellogg. 18-16 Oklahoma State on top. Oh, almost lost it. Travieso. Nope. UMass saves it. Back to Kellogg.
You know what? Oklahoma State is blocking out too close to the basket. A long jump shot is going to rebound longer, so you got to block out a little earlier so you have a chance to not only go backwards to get it, but go forward to get it.
10-27 remaining in the first half. A 9-1 start for UMass. A 17-7 run has put Oklahoma State on top by two.
This is the kind of tempo that Oklahoma State wants. They'll play this long. Well, they don't want to play this long and let him shoot an uncontested shot, and that's something I didn't expect to see from Oklahoma State. An uncontested jump shot.
Derek Kellogg, who played in Springfield, Massachusetts, opposite a different high school, in other words, at the other end, is Rutherford for two.
I'll tell you what, Keyonte Roberts is making some great plays. They thought he could do this at the beginning of his career with him, and he's been inconsistent, but today he's bringing out all the stops.
Off the bench to win our Chevy Player Friday night. And a big start here. 2019, 9:40 to go in the half. Lou Rowe finds Kellogg. Kellogg almost overshadowed in Springfield because the star of that high school scene was Travis Best.
Almost overshadowed? Everybody was looking at Travis Best.
Put back, no good.
You get a stop here because Scott Pierce is standing on the side and Don Rutledge is stopping. It looks like Scott Pierce got hit in the mouth. I mean, you know a lot is at stake, and when that happens, that means you go at it aggressively. You see right there trying to take the pick with Scott, to take the foul with Scott Pierce. You see Big Country on the floor. Everybody's down, but Scott Pierce is the one they're concerned about because it looked as though he got hit just below the nose.
Scott Pierce was starting a beard, went 0 for 7 Friday night, said, to heck with this, shaved it off. Now he's 3 for 3. See, sometimes the magic works. You just got to find out what the magic is.
Guys get so superstitious. You see, Kellogg's got a cut on his elbow, so he's got to go have that taken care of. A lot at stake, guys, putting it on the line. I mean, there's no doubt about it. They'll get that closed up, and the other thing, it's his non-shooting elbow, so he'll be out ready to crank it again shortly.
John Calipari was asked about Derek Kellogg at the press conference yesterday. What about Kellogg attracted him because he wasn't highly recruited? He said heart.
There's no substitute for heart. You got a guy that heart, plays smart, you'll win a lot of games with him.
Big Country Reeves.
Same thing. That was Lou Rowe that time. They can't guard him with Lou Rowe or Weeks. He's just too big.
Reeves, who was outplayed by Tim Duncan the other night, when he had only 15 points. He did have 9 rebounds, and I say outplayed because Duncan had a monster game on the boards, particularly 22, and already Reeves has 10 points.
Well, he not only had a monster game on the boards, but he blocked shots. Duncan played a heck of a game, but Reeves held his own.
Reeves said today would be a challenge because he thought both Camby and Rowe were a little more athletic than he was. Yeah, that's what I mean.
Yeah, he can go get him.
Marcus Camby now has 100 blocks for this season. And over 200 in the 2 years he's been at UMass. Dante Wright, Camby.
when you go to the basket, you got to go up strong. Great pass first over the top. But when you get it, you got to make the play. Marcus Camby said, no, 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 take that back. But you get Brian Country Reeves down there. Watch, there's no way. He just takes a turn. As much as Rose tries, he cannot stop the big fella.
Marcus Camby at the line.
What you like about Marcus Camby, I wouldn't be surprised that if all of a sudden Oklahoma State is applying a lot of pressure on UMass, that Marcus Camby bring the ball up, because there's no way that Brian Reeves can guard Marcus Camby on the perimeter.
That last foul was on Jason Scare, his first 17th foul on Oklahoma State here in the first half.
UMass has found a way to get themselves back in the game, because they now have 7 offensive rebounds to Oklahoma State's 4. So that's 6-1 since the last time we were looking at it.
Andre Owens looks underneath. There's a steal. Owens gets it back.
It's still loose.
Dante Bright.
See, one thing you got to worry about is whether or not kids can settle down a little bit. And Dante Bright at that time did not settle down. Andre Owens just lose the ball. Bright makes a good effort. Dingle comes up with it, but when they throw it to the other end, they throw it right out of bounds.
A tradition
UVA, University of Virginia, will see it. Arkansas comes at you with a great deal of pressure. Curtis Staples and Harold Ingram have got to handle that pressure so they can get in their offense and get it to Junior Burroughs, who's having an outstanding tournament.
Oklahoma State by 1, 7:40 to go, first half. Rutherford out at the point right now. Here comes Andre Owens off the screen, guarded by Derek Kellogg. Rejected by Marcus Camby.
I can see him looking at it. I'm like, oh, that's not a good idea.
That's 2 blocks for Camby in the last couple of minutes. Reeves, Camby almost stole it. Shot clock is at 7.
Oh, they'll get a shot off.
Owens, a spin move in the lane. The tip's too strong. Did not hit the rim.
No, it didn't hit the rim, but it was the reason that they didn't stop the action was because UMass had already taken control of it.
Kellogg kicks it out to Rowe. Camby.
Well, I'm telling you, Andre Owens has stolen the ball. He's got his hands on the ball, and they're getting some great play from people other than you would think, and that's what you got to have. You know that Big Country's going to play, and you expect Rutherford to play, but Andre Owens gets it. Look at this. He just gets his hand on the ball, and Derek Kellogg is lucky to get a jump ball out of that because he almost lost it.
So very early in the season, Oklahoma State faced Arizona, and Andre Owens, who was in his first year at Oklahoma State, faced up against Damon Stoudemire and got it handed to him.
Yeah, he first of all, coming from the junior college, I don't think he thought everybody was as good as they are. And you have to play hard for 40 minutes. That's the lesson he learned playing against Damon Stoudemire, and he's played well since then.
Exactly. From that point, here's another turnover. And a turnover back, but that's going to be off Terry Collins.
But he saved the fast break. Again, you've got to remember, you play against UMass, if you go up or you beat them, they come from behind and make plays.
Tyrone Weeks back on the floor now, number 34. Dingle, Kellogg, Tyrone Weeks, Dante Bright, Lou Rowe.
That's a reset. He kicked the ball. Eddie Sutton is getting what he wants out of his team. They played solid defensively. They've chased down loose balls. You want to get it down to 5 minutes and play a 5-minute game. And so far in the first half, they've done a good job of setting that up.
Rowe, quick move to his left. Pierce gets back and gets some help from Collins. Here's Kellogg. Short, Rowe battles for the rebound. Scott Pierce, who is having a heck of a first half.
But they're getting something from everybody. Keanu Roberts did a heck of a job. Owens did a heck of a job. He's got to get that ball across. Oh, he just made it.
Reeves and Rutherford, along with Owens, Pierce, and Terry Collins right now for Oklahoma State.
And they're just going to slide this down if they can to Big Country.
5. Owens, in the middle.
He's shaking him up. I mean, this kid has played a heck of a game. The question is, as you watch him, he's expending so much energy, does he get worn down?
24-21 with 5:18 to go first half. Dante Bright. Here's Rutherford for Oklahoma State. Kellogg.
Oh, he made dunk this.
Collins can't hang on. You wonder if that problem with his index finger might have hampered him there.
Yeah, because the problem that he will have is that he can't clamp down on it.
UMass has hit two of its last 18 shots.
They've been a lot of pressure, contested shots.
It's defense more than four shots.
Well, without a doubt. They've taken maybe three poor shots, but sometimes a poor shot becomes a poor shot because you get contested.
Eddie Sutton, along with Mr. Ivan, known for their defensive prowess. Here's Bright. He's challenged by Reed.
Well, I would say more Bright challenged Reed, which was a smart move. You can see Oklahoma State is a team that gets after defensively as well. That's what they're known for, the fact that they play 40 minutes of defense, and if they get you into the half-court game, the way they try to improve their field goal percentage is their shot selection, but they want you to play, you know, 40 minutes of defense. Most teams don't want to do that. UMass does a pretty good job of it, but most teams just are not accustomed to laying down and playing that kind of basketball.
Right at the line, shoots two.
When you know it's on the line, you've got to be willing to put your body down. You've got to make it happen. Derek Kellogg, smart play, just goes down and gets it back in. They end up getting a shot on the other end because of that great effort by Derek Kellogg.
Right, one of two. 4.5 to go in the first half of play.
UMass is back their pressure up. I mean, you got to save people, and John Calipari is wise to back this pressure up. Make Lou Rowe play.
Keoni Roberts misfires. Loose ball picked up by Kellogg. But UMass suffering right now through an offensive job like Kentucky suffered yesterday.
Well, that can happen, and one of the things you can do is take the ball to the basket. I think Scott Pierce may have picked up a foul. It might be his third.
It is.
Yeah, he's out on the perimeter trying to guard people, and that's hard for him to do, so he's got to back up and use his size. But right now, he was giving him some play on the glass. He was keeping things alive. Eddie Sutton's going to have to get him out of the game. You'll see right here, he's got two hands up there. He tried to get him back, but you put two hands on a person, I don't care how you do it, they're going to call that every time.
I'm a little surprised Eddie Sutton subbed, but he subbed Terry Collins in for Keoni Roberts, and Scott Pierce stays on the floor with three fouls.
Well, what he'll probably end up doing is getting Keoni Roberts back in the game shortly for Pierce. You don't want to lose Pierce, but Pierce is the one guy they're going to guard Lou Rowe with.
Roberts is already up. Here's Camby. He's got a basket and a free throw. That is also going to be the 10th team foul in the first half against Oklahoma State. Now Roberts is back in.
If you're going to trap, you got to trap. And this is a bad trap coming right here. You see Rutherford come over late. You got to get there and shut it down. If you don't, you allow people to get the basket in a possible three-point play. You can't come and double-team like you're going out for a stroll. This is a sprint. There's a big difference.
Camby misfires at the free throw line. UMass is 8-12 from the line now. But they'll shoot two every time they go to the line from now till the end of the half. Tied at 24. Underneath Big Tecky, another turnover. That's 7 against the Cowboys.
It's a bad decision, good defense by UMass.
Kellogg for Dante Bright.
Got it going up, that should be on Rutherford.
Roberts took the charge, but that was after the foul had already occurred.
Well, and if I'm Rutherford, I don't know why he didn't see that there was help there. There was no need to foul because there was going to be a charge there. Dante Bright was off going, and Rutherford, a senior, should have seen he had help.
Dante Bright, first team McDonald's All-American. We talked Friday night about how he's had to kind of adjust his thinking.
And he's done a good job of it because, you know, as an All-American, a lot of these guys are All-American. It's really hard sometimes to come in and be told that you're not going to be the man. You're going to have to support the men. And he's been able to do that, and he's a big offensive part of what John Calipari tries to get done.
3:28 to go, first half. Television timeout.
Gentlemen, I see the future of insurance.
Where?
Right there.
To find opportunities in insurance, these guys could follow the trends.
This way?
I don't know.
Follow the financial pages.
That way?
Maybe.
Or follow the company with $70 billion in assets.
Where?
Right there.
The company that's always one step ahead, ITT Hartford.
Oh.
For 75 years, ITT, the one to follow.
Look at that new Pontiac Sunfire. Now, if you take yours flying to some other planet, the standard 5-speed and fuel-injected engine will make those light years just kind of zip by. Speaking of the all-new Pontiac Sunfire, do you know how much extra the dual airbags and anti-lock brakes will cost you? That's right. Zero. Nothing. The big O. Finally, a real set of wheels for around $12,500.
Something wonderful is here to tempt you. With tastes you've never had before at breakfast. Kellogg's Temptation Cereal. Irresistible new flavors like honey roasted pecan with twice-baked oven-toasted flakes. Give in to the taste of new Kellogg's Temptations. If the honey roasted pecan doesn't get you, the French vanilla almond will.
ท่าทางเหนื่อยเชียวอย่างนี้แหละต้องรื้อปรับระบบต้องหาคนช่วยเสียเงินแต่ก็ไม่ดีขึ้น
ใช่ว่ะ
อย่างนี้ต้อง IBM
เอ้ยแล้วต้องซื้อฮาร์ดแวร์เพิ่มสิ
ไม่ใช่ IBM อ่ะเขามีบริการปรึกษาการจัดระบบเขาจะมาอยู่กับคุณจนงานเรียบร้อยเลยหุ้นผมขึ้นเลยครับขายเลยครับ
How tough is the game in the East Regional? Well, we have been told that these are parts of what used to be Scott Pierce's tooth.
Well, obviously, that's an aggressive game, but he's got a mouthpiece on, so he's used to getting hit in the mouth. But,
yeah.
You know what? Doesn't seem to faze him. He is missing the tooth. There's no doubt about it.
Yeah, he's... yes, he is. I was about to give a plug there inadvertently.
I thought the better of that.
3:25 to go first half.
Still again, they're backing off that half-court pressure. Another full-court pressure.
Derek Kellogg guards Owens. Big Country Reeves.
They want to swing it to get back to Big Country. If he gets it out on the perimeter, they want to swing it to get it back to him.
He called for it. Rowe flunks him.
No question. No question about it. It's a good call.
Foul is on Lou Rowe, his first. John Calipari.
If you're guarding Bryant Reeves, you got to stay behind him. First of all, you see Rowe gets over there late, and then he pushed him. And what the fans were hoping for was a travel, but the travel occurred because he got pushed.
Only the 15th foul. Rutherford for three. He's missed every one of them so far today. But he won't quit putting it up, I promise.
No, he's a scorer, and he's got to keep putting the shot up if they're to be able to get a chance to get it inside.
Reeves have 10 so far, can be 6. UMass started out 4 of 5 from the field, and they've gone sour since then. 25-26-24, however, UMass leads.
The problem with Marcus Camby taking that shot, it takes him off the glass. He cannot rebound if he's taking turnaround.
We talked about tempo early in this ballgame. How do you like it so far for Oklahoma State?
It slowed down. I mean, you see that they're running their offense, Oklahoma State, and when they're running their offense, they're forcing you to play defense, which is exactly what Eddie Sutton said he wanted them to do. Make them play defense.
Well, we have received confirmation now in our quest for the truth that those three little pieces of tooth once resided in Scott Pierce's mouth. He shattered his incisor. So we got the tooth problem solved, or at least reported. Now we're going to deal with the dirty hand that we're showing you.
But I've got to tell you, I mean, look at him. That doesn't even bother him.
No. Well, he's from Euless, Texas. He's a tough kid. Oh, okay. I'm sorry. I forgot. Texas. The whole deal. My mistake.
That's your hometown, no?
Yes, it is my hometown.
One, don't violate.
Trinity High School in Euless, Texas. Roberts misses. Rebound, Camby. 2:27 to go first half. UMass up by two.
You see, Marcus Camby bringing it down. I mean, that's an option they have. That's one way to spare Travieso and Kellogg from having handled the ball all the time.
Travieso tries to dish it to Lou Rowe. Saved by Travieso. Single with a dandy foot.
What a very athletic move, but it was a smart play by Travieso to stay active.
Lead is four. Andre Owens, who's had a wonderful first half.
You got to go inside, though, Andre. You've got to get the ball inside to Reeves.
Reeves established. Now they front him again. Lou Rowe. Well, locks out. Takes the jumper. Off the mark.
They called it on Keontae Roberts. He and Dana Dino got tied up. You got to be able to get the ball inside sometime. Brian Reeves gets the position, and you'll see Lou Rowe three-quartering. They call that three-quarter on the three-quarter side. And then all of a sudden, Reeves has to break back out to the top of the key to get the ball. This shot, Eddie Sutton can make. You see the pressure by Marcus Camby. Short, and they call a foul on Keontae Roberts on Dana Dingle's back.
As we told you a moment ago, two shots every trip to the line from now to the end of the half. And Dana Dingle will be there now. Two of two so far.
Dana Dingle's a guy they like for his defensive presence. What they will do is play him at the shooting guard defensively. And if Dante Bright is in the game, he'll play the shooting guard offensively.
See, UMass hasn't put Oklahoma State in the bonus yet. One of two, just stripped down. Keontae Roberts with a rebound. 1:44 to go first half, a five-point UMass lead.
The other problem that Oklahoma State was having, Randy Rutherford hadn't gotten going, so they don't have to necessarily worry about chasing him out.
Rutherford had 23 in the win Friday night of a Wake Forest. Still hasn't gotten it. Collins loses the ball, and that is the eighth first-half turnover for Oklahoma State.
Well, you got to be able to make plays. Collins is going to be active, but Brian Reeves does a good job keeping it open. They're fortunate that they only got the ball out of bounds, because that very well could have been an offensive foul.
Believe it or not, that is Terry Collins' first turnover of the tournament. That's how well they've played so far.
That's part of Eddie Sutton's system. What he talks about is, let's teach our guys to be as fundamentally sound as we can, and then we don't have to be as concerned about the opposition. What we have to do is just play sound basketball.
Jason Scare in the lineup now for Oklahoma State. Here's Stingle.
That's Keontae Roberts.
Right.
I mean, all of a sudden, you look at Lou Rowe is flying out. He looked like he had an S on his chest. There are two ways to be a rebound. The one is to have the ability to jump. The other is to block out. Now watch. Lou Rowe gets position here. Now he blocks out on the offensive side. Keontae Roberts. The ball goes up. Roberts pushes him and picks up his third foul.
Second Oklahoma State Cowboy with three. He joins Scott Pearson foul trouble and sends Lou Rowe to the lineup. John Calipari, I started to say earlier in the ballgame, had some comments about what Lou Rowe had meant. Somebody asked him to compare him to Julius Erving. And John Calipari said, now that's unfair to Lou Rowe. Julius Erving was Julius Erving. Nobody will ever replace the doctor. But what Lou Rowe did is elevate this program and keep the elevation to a level it's never achieved before.
I'll tell you what he did. He's been selfless. He's had a chance. If they ask him to score points, he can score points. He does whatever the team asks. When your senior does that, your underclassmen don't have much choice.
UMass crowd getting into it. Their team up by seven now. Been a drop for Oklahoma State at this end of the floor.
They let him get the ball. That's too easy.
Roberts saves it.
What Lou Rowe had been doing good is he was funning him, which means he gets on the top side of him and just stay on the ball side. Because most of the time in the post, you play under people. He got on the high side. That's why they didn't get him the ball.
About a four-second differential, shot clock, game clock. Reeves He spent a little time in the paint.
He definitely spent more than a little time. He had at least 2.5 seconds. That's what the officials felt. Otherwise, they'd have made a 3-second call.
He was asking for Dean Meal money in there.
Yeah, he kind of settled in. I'll give you that.
Lip readers understood exactly what Calipari just said.
I think he's a little disappointed that there wasn't a, you know, a cot in there. You don't go sleep, you might as well have a cot.
Owens for two. Cuts the lead to 6.
This guy, John Calipari, had his team. They were so loose. I mean, when they came out and shot around, I mean, the guys were goofing around. And some environments work that way. Because guys can't play if they get real tight.
One, two, putback. Got it. Keyonny Roberts again.
Just a missed block out. Keyonny Roberts has been around the ball and making plays the entire time. Missed a couple shots.
Reeves switches on Kellogg. He takes the 3.
Boy, that was a good chance. They could have called basket interference because Reeves just about touched the basket as the ball was in the cylinder.
I believe they got Keyonny Roberts with a foul. It's his 4th.
Boy, that hurts them because they lose some athletic ability there. The ball had come out of there, but he definitely hit the rim. So to get Roberts over the back for his 4th.
That's a major loss for Oklahoma State.
Well, it's one that they're going to have a tough time being able to play with because it'll take his aggressiveness away in the second half, and that's what he brought to the team.
And it brings up a reiteration of the point we made earlier. This is not a deep Oklahoma State team. Lou Rowe misfires on the first. They normally only play 7. Roberts and Jason Scare off the bench.
I'll tell you what they really miss, athletic ability in a lot of ways, and Keontae was the most athletic they had on the floor.
One shot they counted. We are at halftime. Keyonny Roberts with 4 fouls. His Oklahoma State team have the lead. Fell behind at the end of the half. 32-27 on halftime score. UMass up by 5.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of this NCAA one thoughtful call.
Second half at the Meadowlands in East Rutherford, New Jersey. UMass, the number 2 seed, up by 5 over Oklahoma State. Not only is Oklahoma State trailing by those 5 points, Quinn, they've got real foul problems now with Keyonny Roberts and Scott Pierce.
And they lose all of the activity they were getting. That energy they were getting off the bench with Keyonny Roberts and Scott Pierce out there while he was playing is important because now they can't be as aggressive because you can't get that kind of play from the rest of the team. I think you've got to start throwing the ball inside. But before you do that, you need to be able to make some jump shots. They have not been doing that very well. You see, they've made none from the 3-point lane. Everything that they've made is in the paint. The guards, it's good that they get in the paint, but in order to get Big Country going, you got to make some perimeter jump shots.
Take a look at the other stats in the game. UMass, only 29% from the field, but look at that.
That's huge. I mean, your point is perfect. 29% from the field, and you shoot that kind of get to the foul line. They got to the double bonus early. And the double bonus, ladies and gentlemen, is when you get over 10 fouls, you automatically get 2 shots. That allowed them to get the opportunity to shoot them. But what put them in position was they just drove the ball to the basket.
Let's check in again with Andrea Joyce.
All right, Vern. Vern, UMass beat its first three opponents in this year's tournament by an average of 21 points. Now, before the game, Calipari told his players this Oklahoma State squad is 20 points better than any team they've faced this season, so they're not surprised that they've been able to hang with them in the first half. UMass does believe, however, that they've got to get a lot more physical in the second half. They've got to cut down on Oklahoma State's offensive boards. Oklahoma State, meantime, concerned about those fouls, as you mentioned, Quinn, and they'll also try to punch the ball inside more to Reeves. Back to you guys.
Yeah, but if you notice, Coach Calipari said to hold them by 20 points. You know there's a one-point difference that favored UMass. I mean, that's the coach working on the psyche of the players. They're 20 points better, but they're not 21 points better.
Collins, Pierce, Owens, Reeves, and Randy Rutherford. Keani Roberts, who comes off the bench, stays there to start this half. We'll see how long he sits with four fouls. Reeves, way outside. Owens peers inside, trying to find Collins. Here's Big Country Reeves. Blocked by Camby, that's his third. That was a pass there. He was trying to pass the ball to Scott Pierce. At the other end, Reeves will rebound. Oklahoma State trailing at the half by five. They have trailed seven times at halftime this year, won only once.
That's Terry Collins. He's the one guy that has a chance to get going inside. He did it the other night against Wake Forest, and he's going to have to come alive because Keani Roberts was on the floor with three fouls going into half. That's a tough situation. Offensive foul, Marcus Campbell.
Wow.
Well, Brian Reeves is trying to show you he has some foot speed. If he just maintains position, which he does, I would suggest to you, maybe a little harder to knock him down than that, but Marcus Camby on the other side has his own way of playing defense. That's going up. See, he was going to pass it. Lou Rowe got to it, but had he not gotten to it, Marcus Camby was waiting.
Scott Pierce kicks it back outside to Andre Owens. A three-point edge now. UMass trying to get to the Final Four for the first time in the history of the school. Pierce. Yes.
He gets the shot because Marcus Camby isn't coming to guard him. He's trying to help on Big Country, so he's letting Pierce take that shot. If Pierce makes that, that opens it up for Reeves as well.
Cowboys open with a quick two field goals. Shave the lead to one. Here's Derek Kellogg, the senior guard. Again, Edgar Padilla, who started after the team dismissed Mike Williams, is not playing today. There's a turnaround jumper from Camby is good. Padilla out with an injured arch. He hurt the arch Friday night.
Man, that injury is a difficult injury to handle. I want to tell you, unless I'm crazy, he took deep travel.
He learned to walk as a boy and thought it might be useful in later life.
Hey, if I don't get caught, I guess I can try it.
Traviesa, the pitch to Rowe. The putback, no. And the block from Reeves.
I don't know how you miss a shot that close. I mean, he was standing right there. Dingle was right there. He's got to finish. The penetration by Travieso is very good. He gets in the teeth of the defense, and Lou Rowe gets knocked off balance. Right there, Dana Dingle, he just short strokes it and gives Big Country a chance to get over there. He blocks it on his shoes ball.
Scott Pierce, big game. 0 for 7 the other night. What a comeback. Here's Rutherford. That's what they need to come out.
If he starts looking at, boy, he makes it very difficult to play against offensively.
Randy Rutherford is now 1 for 5 from three-point range. Rowe with a turnaround. Off the mark. Oklahoma State. They are trying to get back to the Final Four for the first time in 44 years.
Well, one of the things they have going for them in terms of rebounding, Randy Rutherford had 11 rebounds last game. He can get to the goal for you.
Camby way up in the air. For UMass. Carmelo Travieso gets it back to Kellogg. Rutherford, big rebound for Oklahoma State.
He's one of the best rebounding guards in the country.
Owens didn't quite get the roll.
Yeah, but the play is made by Rutherford, and what really helps is anytime you can get a guy to take it off the glass, he makes it hard for you to get in transition. This is the rebound. He pushes it up. You see Travieso try to get back. Kellogg tries to play. Both men comes over. He gets a hand foul on Travieso. Rutherford makes the play by just pushing it up the court.
Derek Kellogg picks up his third foul, and Andre Owens goes to the line.
Now, we've got to keep an eye on that because that's another place where you don't have Padilla. So the rotation changes then. That's when they'll look to put maybe Dante Bright back there offensively, Dana Dingell on the two-man defensively.
Mike Williams, the starter, kicked off the team 12 games ago. A variety of disciplinary problems. Edgar Padilla took over, strained his arch the other night. Another young man from Springfield. He played with Travis Best and unable to go today. And now Kellogg picks up his third foul.
You know, the thing with Michael Williams, and this is the way it affected the team seems to have been positive. There's been so much trouble or concern about what's going to happen with Michael Williams that the team got distracted. That distraction got removed, and they just started to play stronger and stronger and stronger, and that's why they're here today.
Tyrone Weeks, an official timeout, but he's okay. And Dingell will inbound with Kellogg now for UMass. Massachusetts, located in the lovely city of Amherst. Dingell, Kellogg. 36-34, Oklahoma State. A 9-2 run in this half. Johnny Esser. Oh, yeah, loaded up. Loaded up.
You penetrate, you break the defense down, and that's what happened there. And Trevi Esso just ended up just flaring out to the corner and got a jump shot, and it was not an uncontested shot.
UMass by one. Reeves. Pierce again. Whoa! Hell ball, possession arrow, UMass.
Pierce was trying to take it off the dribble. And when he does that, you've got to be aware that there's a guy that's going to be around the basket. He's setting records. Marcus Camby will get over there, and he just throws it right out. Randy Rutherford comes to help because of the dribble penetration and the three by Traviesa.
Very nice.
Oh, thank you.
I'm going to hang with you. I learned stuff. Sometimes about basketball.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, I'm going to get geography lessons for you.
Sir.
You gotta stay active and try to get some baskets if you're UMass. They do right here on the good pass. Lou Rowe just misses a bunny, and you see coming over the back is Marcus Camby. That's because Scott Pierce blocked out earlier. And when you block out earlier, sometimes it surprises people. Marcus Camby picked up his third foul with that surprise.
And that is the third team foul of the half. Oklahoma State hasn't fouled yet in this half. They were in trouble in the first half. Again, a reminder, Keonti Roberts on the bench with four. Scott Pierce plays with three.
They got it right on the block.
There it is.
They set up him on the other side, and with the ball got to him while he was under the basket, so he was able to get it. Sometimes people wait until he's out of the lane. He got it under the basket and just turned the shot.
Big Country Reeves with another. He's got 12, 38-37. Tyrone Weeks. Kellogg. Here's Dante Bright, number four. Reeves with a rebound.
And with the help, he came over and kind of blocked the sight of Dante Bright. That's why he shot it on the side of the glass.
Reeves comes right side.
You got to go back to Reeves if he gets a basket.
Rutherford's a pretty good alternative.
Well, you got to have alternatives. And I think we've seen enough. Just John Calipari.
Foodless. Foodless means nothing could stop you. Not a patch of ice, not a drift of snow. It was a great idea then, and it still is. Around the world.
Fort Smith moved it back to Gans. He said, "Ah, it's too big a tent." Carl Reeves flew into LaGuardia here in New York yesterday. Here comes Travieso. It's too strong. The putback is good. And it's a 41-39 score.
In case you don't know who scored that, they always say lose when Lou Rowe gets going a little bit.
41-39. Owens and Rutherford, Pierce, Terry Collins, Ryan Reeves. Oklahoma State by two.
To shoot much as you can, you either get the ball right there. There's no chance that Lou Wilson guards. He's just too big. If they swing the ball, you get a chance for Bryant to get better position, because what he does is he starts high and he'll rotate low, and that'll open up for him.
Reeves with 14 points. Carmelo Travieso gets it in the hands of David Dingle. Now they reverse it. Lou Rowe playing out high. A 4-point lead, Oklahoma State.
But you see that all of a sudden the tempo slowed down just a little bit.
UMass misfires. Here comes Owens. Pierce. Oh, yes!
You know, that's what they did a lot in the first half. I was a little surprised that they ran as much as they did, but Terry Collins makes a nice pass up to Scott Pierce. They just threw the ball over the top because UMass wasn't doing a very good job getting back defensively.
Scott Pierce may start shaving four times a day.
He's got to feel good about the way he played today.
12 points after an 0 for Friday night, after which he shaved off the beginning of a beard. Here's Pierce. A 6-point Oklahoma State lead.
Lou Rowe comes to a 2-foot jump stop, and people tend to stop playing. That's what Oklahoma State did, and when they did, he just kept going because the officials rightly didn't call it.
We have 12:35 remaining in this game. It should be noted that Friday night, Wake Forest had a 6-point lead on Oklahoma State with 11:28 to go. Oklahoma State came back to win that one, obviously. Collins.
All day. I mean, it's just all day long. Lou Rowe is trying as hard as he can, but what happens is he tries to push the country out. It wears him down, and he's a little worn down because you know this country's getting closer and closer to the basket.
Underneath the row.
See, he's trying to carry it on the offensive end. That was a good foul. And I say it's a good foul. He's trying to get it to be an intentional foul. But there was a fast break situation going there for sure.
Foul is on Dana Dingle, his second and the fourth team foul. Oklahoma State still has not committed a foul in this half. Marcus Camby comes back in. Winner gets UCLA next Saturday in Seattle. North Carolina's already in. UVA and Arkansas play later this afternoon. The winner gets the Tar Heels.
Two great games yesterday. I mean, UCLA came out. I mean, they're still having trouble getting people to respect them. They're number one ranked team in the country. They played a heck of a game yesterday. And North Carolina with this win over Kentucky.
Owens, Jason Scare, too far into the basket. Lou Rowe has it.
He got excited. He should have just taken a step back and brought it down.
Yellow, he just fouled out.
Keontae Roberts just fouled out on just a bad play. You got four fouls. You can't go in and reach for the ball like that.
He had just come off the bench. He was on the floor for 23 seconds.
You've got to be smart. You're coming in, you got four fouls. There's nothing that happened here. There's nothing wrong with being aggressive, but be smart with the aggressiveness. And now Camby picks up a foul over the back.
That's his fourth
foul, and John Calipari is telling him to go around. To stop trying to go over the top.
Jeff Meyer, a 7'2" senior who doesn't play a lot, will have an opportunity now.
What he does have, though, is he's got hot, which may be somewhat of a distraction for big countries having played against Lou Rowe. But now you start to see where the depth really is for both teams.
Roberts is out. Camby plays with four. Jeff Meyer, number 33, from Wausau, Wisconsin, out guarding Scott Pierce. Big country. Rowe's over the back. No foul. think there was contact.
Oh, I don't think there's any question about it.
All day. Jeff Meyer blocked that from the back. At 7-2, Jeff Meyer.
Offensive foul, Dante Bright. You got to be able to get some production off your bench because you know your starters will give it to you. You come off the bench, you come in, and one thing you want to do is play defense. You see Jeff Meyer get over there and stop the follow through there on Big Country. There was no foul. That's a good defensive play. Come back the other end. We talked about getting charges, and that's what happened on the other end. They got a charge, but Eddie Sutton wants to talk about it.
Oklahoma State calls time. And Kellogg for UMass with 4-3. Here's a reversal of the first half, Quinn.
Yeah, because all of us. Oklahoma State has taken the ball to the basket more, and that's what started to happen near the end of the first half for UMass. You've got to expose people to fouls. Now, the question becomes, when does fatigue become a factor?
Here's Big Country Reeves, who played 40 minutes the other night. That long shot by Collins off the mark. Reeves has played all but 9 minutes of the tournament so far. He sat out the last nine in the first round game.
Well, what's amazing about that is I did one of his first game as a freshman in the tournament, and his stamina was the question mark, and he's obviously developed that.
47-41, Oklahoma State up by one. They have won 15 of their last 18. UMass, of course, only 4 losses on the year. 2 to George Washington. Rebound, Oklahoma State.
Push it up, you can get numbers. When they start trapping like that, you can get numbers if you push it up. But here's what UMass is running into offensively. With Marcus Camby on the bench, Lou Rowe takes the shot. They don't have the rebounding presence on the other side.
Big Country. Jeff Meyer guards it. I would think they'll try and get it into it. Owens, short.
Oh, he took his bucket away.
In the hands of Big Country. Yeah!
Playing. You see all of a sudden Oklahoma State coming up with the scratch plays. Those plays UMass has got to make.
Cowboys by 8. What an effort by Andre Owens.
Oh, he knew right away he missed it, and he makes a bad play there. But he knew right away he missed it.
No basket.
The one person that knows whether or not they missed a shot generally is the guy who took it. Andre Owens knows right now he's missing. Now he's already coming in. Lou Rowe turns to him, Andre Owens takes it, and before Lou Rowe can get back, gets it up, and then Country gets it and finishes it over Jeff Meyer.
Andre Owens' second foul, that is the second team foul. And look at these shooting percentages from UMass.
They've had a lot of pressure. Now, we want to take a look now. They've just taken Andre Owens off the bench. They don't really have a true point guard on the floor. I'm curious to see if John Calipari decides to increase the pressure on in full court.
Kellogg for UMass finds Tyrone Weeks. 9 minutes to go. Oklahoma State by 8. Kellogg.
Got to play Anthony. He got to play Anthony.
49-43.
See, they got Randy Rutherford. See, they go out to trap it, and that's what you got to do. Randy Rutherford is not really a point guard. He can handle the ball, but I trap it and get it out of his hands.
Scaring Rutherford, Big Country Reeves. Another one.
But now he's just in rhythm, because Jeff Meyer got a hand up where you want it, and you want him to shoot over it. Country's in rhythm now.
51-43, Reeves.
Oh, good read.
Jason Scare, the freshman.
Coaching college.
today.
I mean, look at that. Is that unbelievable? But just think about this. Eddie Sutton is a very, very solid coach. This is the only guy in NCAA history to take four separate schools to the NCAA tournament. So they've gotten quality coaches.
Creighton, Arkansas, Kentucky, and Oklahoma State is alma mater. Camby plays with four fouls. He's back on the floor.
And he couldn't get that rebound over the top of Randy Rutherford because he was afraid to get his fifth.
Oklahoma State 53-43. 7:59 to go. They are the number four seed.
I tell you what, that timeout really helped Oklahoma State, because I tell you what happened. It allowed that additional timeout, allowed Andre Owens to get a breather, and they got him back in the game.
And he plays with Randy Rutherford. There's a near steal by Travieso. Here's Big Country. Tyrone Weeks puts a body on him. Camby, loose ball.
The problem is they can't get a shot off. They got to get the ball up there.
One.
Oh.
Oh, boy.
It didn't hit the rim. That was the problem they had. It was 6 seconds going out of bounds.
Shot clock violation. Substitutions now. Dana Dingle and Lou Rowe come back in.
Right there. They call that not a change of possession. And that's why the shot clock didn't reset. Andre Owens looked up to try to figure out how much time he had and just threw it at the basket. Didn't hit the rim. No reset.
Recall that this UMass team trailed West Virginia by 17 points with 5 minutes to go in the middle of the season.
What they did, they were fresher, they had more bodies. They don't have the bodies necessarily to pull that off. They've been playing hard, and in the tournament, the emotion will wear you down as well.
Scott Pierce, what a huge game he's had. J.C. Scare gets it for Rutherford.
Oh, my goodness!
The lead is 13, and 13 points for Randy Rutherford.
I mean, he stepped up to that one with a nice ball fake and then a dribble, a reverse dribble for a shot.
Camby at the other end, Jason Scare.
And replacing Keontae Roberts, I'm telling you, that bench has been of tremendous value. Scare played well, obviously Roberts had played well.
Reeves.
So he's on a roll, but Camby can't do anything.
UMass. Oklahoma State Cowboys lead by 15. These young men are trying to restore the glamour and the tradition of a program that was one of the most dominant in the country 50 years ago. They won back-to-back championships in 45 and 46. There was a reunion held earlier this year of these men. Remarkably, every one of the players on that 45 team is still alive. All but three made it back to Stillwater for the reunion. They were led by Bob Kierlin, who's in retirement in Florida now, one of the legendary first big men in college basketball.
Well, they needed that. Coming out of the timeout, they needed that basket bad, and it was a three-pointer. See, the other thing that helps them, they're a better pressing team after they score. They can get set up better.
Here comes Andre Owens across the timeline, hit from behind by Dana Dingle. And that is the seventh team foul.
John Calipari was screaming, "What are you doing? There's nothing he can do there."
We don't need the foul. Brian Reeves, 22 points, 5 rebounds. Look at the interior play and the edge to Oklahoma State.
Brian Reeves has scored, but the other thing he does, he started attracting so much attention that Jason Scare started getting the ball to Collins. That's why the interior storm is as it is.
Carmelo Travieso. At the other end, Dingle. Oh.
Now he can go plead as much as he wants. He picks up his second foul trying to make a play. There's no chance. He tries to get over to make the play, and he wants to say he got over there and he was standing and his arms went straight up. Well, he moved over to get there. Dana Dingle did a good job of moving it away from him. Straight up doesn't mean zigzag. It means straight up. I think Scott Pierce has either a cut under his eye or a bloody nose. They're going to get him. He's got to go off. So they may have to put, well, they can't put Jason Scarry in because he just sat down. I mean, this kid, you're talking about taking some shots.
Lost the tooth.
Exactly, lost the tooth. He's got a bloody nose.
He may be a tiny bit less handsome tonight than he was this morning.
But what's at stake? If they come out with a W, that's the risk you take.
Scott Pierce, what a game he has played. 12 points. And there's a possibility, of course, that he might be our Chevrolet player of the game because at the conclusion of every NCAA tournament game, that's called a segue.
I learned so much from you.
Oh, yeah. That's my disc jockey days. We'll select the Chevrolet players of the game in conjunction with the award. Chevrolet will donate $1,000 to the general scholarship fund of both schools.
Well, you know what happened? John Nelson just came in the game. They want Jason Scarry in, but I believe Jason Scarry was the guy that Pierce had been in for, so he would have to sit out.
Dingle misses the first. He's now 3 of 5 at the line.
Yeah, they're telling him he can't go back in the game. He's got to stay there and wait till the next possession.
Reeves is going to argue about it.
Reeves' question is probably about as to whether or not that was a two-shot foul.
Shooting two, yeah.
Yeah, that's what he's asking. Yeah, that's Steve Wilmer there just trying to be sure about Jason Scarry as to why he can't come in the game. Reeves is trying to say that that was not a two-shot foul. Everybody trying to plead their case.
Big Country is not majoring in debating.
Well, he doesn't have a very good case. You got to have a case of some kind.
The lead is 12, 5:35 to go. The UMass team in the Final Eight for the first time. They have never been to the Final Four. John Nelson, number 45, who gets the ball into Reeves. Now in the hands of Andre Owens. Working the clock. We've got 9 on the shot clock.
But they make you play defense this entire time, and they got Big Country if they want to go to him.
Collins. Short. Rebound, Lou Owens. Canby wanted the alley-oop.
He wanted the alley-oop, but Reeves did a good job of getting back, so the alley-oop would have been a tough pass to make, and you can't afford to throw it away now.
Marcus Canby runs into John.
Whoa! How about that? But I tell you what really helped, having John Nelson in the game, because when Marcus Canby did his turn, Reeves got faked out, but Nelson was so big that Canby had to change his shot.
John Nelson, number 45.
Watch. When you take a look at it, this is Nelson comes. See, Canby turns there, and Nelson is so big and strong, he never moved him. And then Terry Collins just goes over the top.
He's another big, steady guy. Freshman from West Fork, Arkansas.
Am I going to get a geography lesson?
No, no, not yet. That's late.
I know I'm due for one.
Terry Collins goes to the line. You ever been to Stillwater?
No, I have not. But they've turned out some pretty good football players, too. That I know. Thurman Thomas and Barry Sanders. And I'm telling you, Barry Sanders will turn you around.
Canby with a rebound. The lead is 12 with 4:48 remaining. The winner goes to Seattle. Foul on Jason Scare, number 43. That's his second. And the fourth team foul. Coming next, 5 o'clock Eastern time. Virginia, Arkansas, defending the national champions.
I like Nola Richardson talking about the fat lady singing. So she's not singing. She may be humming, but she's not singing on us just yet. They've had one-point games, and they've just overtime games. This is about staying alive and surviving, and they've been able to do it.
Kellogg shoots two.
Now, that's the exact opposite of the halftime, which it was 14 of 20 for UMass. And you can see the difference is the penetration. You go to the basket, you probably going to get fouled.
Got them both. It's 10 points. One other note. Inbound pressure. Rutherford has it. Now they get it to Owens.
Wide open.
Here's Reeves. Oh, my goodness.
If you're not sure of it, he did the right thing. That's what a senior does. If you're not sure of it, don't take it in there half-heartedly.
Now he gets it in there. The double from Kellogg. They work on the clock a little bit. No. Kellogg, 2-on-2. Canby.
That fourth foul really bothers Marcus Camby. He will not take the ball up strong. Reeves behind him, afraid that he might get his fifth.
The lead is 10, the time 4:05.
Timeout, Oklahoma State.
Timeout, Oklahoma State. They have one left.
I stopped by my Cadillac dealer and looked at the new DeVille. Impressive.
Fouls 4-8. OSU has the possession arrow. And they have committed only one turnover in this half. Remember, in defeating Wake Forest the other night, traveling, now they've got two.
The pressure coming out of the timeout was too much for Andre Owens. I'm sure there was a little body contact there, but you've got to be able to withstand that and still make your play.
Kellogg has the inbound pass. Dante Bright, Luro, Camby, and Carmelo Travieso on the floor for UMass.
The key is to taking the charges because you get in front of people. Initially, Kellogg made the penetration, and what Brian Reeves did was read it. You got to get yourself in position to help teammates. That's so important as you see Kellogg down, and they can ill afford to lose him. See, he goes in, Reeves gets there, and as Reeves goes down, I think his elbow hits him on the jaw. Try to get to the basket, and Reeves will get there. Now watch his right elbow. See, he comes down with it as he's falling, and he definitely hit him in the jaw. I do believe it was unintentional, though.
Kellogg picks up his fourth foul, will stay on the floor. Heart.
Heart and necessity for John Calipari. He has very few options, but they need to get Kellogg back on the floor as soon as they can.
That's the ninth team foul. Brian Reeves shoots 1-1. 2 of 3 today.
Been able to get some penetration and some help, but Brian Reeves throwing down on the block has made a big difference for this team.
Free throw shooting has been an Achilles heel for Oklahoma State in losses earlier this year. They are 3 of 12 from the line right now.
Oh, boy, I'm telling you, that's unfortunate. Dante Bright makes a good move into the middle and gets there and couldn't get a handle on the ball, and it goes off of Lou Rowe.
That's 9 turnovers for UMass. The pressure, oops. Owens almost threw it away. Back in the hands of Jason Skaer. S-K-A-E-R. 3:27 to go. The lead is 10.
They'll try to do, I'm sure, in that timeout, what Eddie Sutton said is, look, there's no need to be in a hurry. Let's hold our offense. We can always go inside and let Bryant try it if we have to.
Clock at 2. That's off the mark.
Oh, big rebound.
Offensive rebound, Scott Pierce.
He has just been big for them. I mean, he's come up with loose balls, been very, very active for them. And Keontae Roberts, who had a great first half, and Pierce is picking up for them in the second half.
Guarded by Kellogg, who can't get too aggressive with that fourth foul.
Now, not only that, he'll have a tough time not only getting the ball from Owens, but he's going to expose the team to get broken down if he reaches and gets beat.
Underneath. No foul off Reeves.
And what Reeves is saying is the pass he made got knocked off on the other side. I think I agree with you. There's a pass that goes up, but I thought there was somebody from UMass came and hit the ball. It's a tough call, but I... Oh, Carrieta! Back it down, Thomas.
2:22 to play. Carmelo Travieso.
Well, that's what the three-point shot will do. It'll get you back in the game quickly.
Reeves finds Rutherford.
They get timeout.
They use their final timeout. 2:06 remaining. 7-point lead, Cowboys. or UVA or Arkansas, that game is next. Both teams out of timeouts. It's Oklahoma State's the inbound. Randy Rutherford will put it in to Ryan Reeves. Now in the hands of Andre Owens.
Again, with just a good patience, they can get shots anytime they want.
Rutherford.
And he was fouled. I mean, he makes a heck of a shot. They took his legs off him under there, and he's able to drill a three.
Rutherford with 16. Most in this half. Reeves has it at the other end. Here's Rutherford again.
Once he got three fouls, he became tentative, and his team could not really get a whole lot out of it. But you know that the team that's been aggressive and been able to take it to the basket has been Oklahoma State. Randy Rufford just knocks down the three, but there you can see that the Cowboys are excited, and well, they should be because they played a good game. There's still a minute 23 to go.
Could this be Marcus Camby's last game at UMass? Only he knows. Brian Reeves apparently will have at least one more. He goes to the line. Big country.
Well, if they play, if this stays as it is, and they'll play UCLA, they have not met this year. The last time they played was 1974. That's the year North Carolina State won it.
Patsy Sutton. One of her sons sits on the bench with his dad, Sean Sutton, who played for Eddie at Kentucky and Oklahoma State. 65-51. Sutton missed. Rebound, Scott Pierce.
Well, they've been one shot and out for UMass, but their problem is they've worn down. I mean, they've tried to stay into the game, but their legs are worn down. They've had to work so hard. Not having Padilla has been part of that.
There's Sean Sutton. He was an outstanding guard, both at Kentucky and at Oklahoma State. Now an assistant to his father. In 1978, Eddie Sutton took an Arkansas team to the Final Four. An Arkansas team led by Sidney Moncrief, Marvin Zelf, and Ron Brewer. He's just 80 seconds away from taking his alma mater to the Final Four for the first time in 44 years.
But what's got to be even better about it is to have your son on the bench. But as they tried to turn the program around, it was Sean who really became the glue when they first got there. So this is, for them, you know, to be able to do this with your son has got to be very exciting.
Derek Kellogg leaving the game. What a career at UMass.
Gave it all he had. And that's just what John Calipari said. He said, what a great career. Gave it all he had today, just did not have enough.
Rutherford shoots another. In and out, rebound, Travieso.
All right, back to UCLA and Oklahoma State. Soon that happens. The common opponents that they have are Arizona, Arizona State, and Missouri. Oklahoma's only 2-3 with that. They beat Missouri and LSU, who is the other one. But they're going to have trouble because they play Arizona, and they did not get them. And UCLA beat them twice.
Andre Owens gets another one. 17 points. The jumper, got it. Nunez. Rigoberto Nunez gets three. The Cowboys bring it across the timeline. Lou Rowe and Derek Kellogg have played their final game for UMass.
I'll tell you what, in 4 years to not only win the conference regular season, but the tournament too, that has been done very rare in college basketball. That says a lot about what those kids have done for UMass.
20 seconds remaining before the trip is made from Stillwater to Seattle.
Keep it light, this country.
Scott Pierce with another steal.
Those are the plays that you got to have when you're trying to go for the whole deal.
after it throws it for a ride. Of this Oklahoma State program. I mean, they were one of the giants of college basketball back in the 40s and 50s under Henry Ivey. And now a graduate of Oklahoma State, Eddie Sutton, has brought his team back to the Final Four. They play UCLA. We're going to name two MVPs for Chevrolet. Big Country Reeves and Scott Pierce for Oklahoma State. Senior Lou Rowe for UMass. We'll be back to talk to the victors from East Rutherford, New Jersey, right after this. You got the-
Big inside game against a tough team in Virginia. Let's go back out to East Rutherford now, where Vern Lundquist is standing by. Oklahoma State beating Massachusetts 68-54. Vern, you're on.
Okay, Patrick, and I'm standing by with Eddie Sutton.